Yeah, this is wild. A mystery for 15 years. Missing artwork is found here. And only our cameras are there as the historic work goes back on display. The metal sculpture was the first public contemporary art piece here in Pittsburgh.
Made by local sculptor Peter Calaboyas. After it disappeared, it took him years to find it. Channel 4 Action News anchor Michelle Wright joins us with this story. Michelle.
Oh, and I love this story, Andrew and Wendy. If you've lived around Pittsburgh a while, you may even recognize this. It was the first contemporary piece of outdoor art installed here. And his search for that work ended in a most unusual place. Finally, today, Peter Calaboyas' art has a new home for all of us to enjoy once again.
Peter Calaboyas is an amazing sculptor. Crafted from his Shadyside workshop, his art is enjoyed internationally. One of his best-known pieces was done for the 96 Olympics in Atlanta and became infamous when a bomb exploded right beside it and damaged it. Still a major tourist attraction. But his style started with this. It's called Five Factors, done in 1972 and installed in front of the Carnegie Library in Squirrel Hill at the corner of Forbes and Murray. He called it a gateway for other emerging artists.
It opened up wonderful opportunities for other young artists, which we have scattered throughout Pittsburgh now.
When the library expanded, his work was removed for safekeeping, but then lost. For 15 years, he searched and searched.
I was looking for him for years. I kept calling the city.
And then finally, he found it. Crews had discarded Five Factors under the 62nd Street Bridge with scrap.
I was shocked. Well, first of all, I was glad to find them, but then I was disappointed they were really beyond repair. I was terrible to see all the work just cast aside.
But after a few years of restoration and recreation, Peter was on hand, beaming with pride, as the work that kicked off his career was given a new home in Mellon Park in East Liberty.
Because it was the very first significant work that developed in this competition, to see it restored is just a wonderful feeling.
He designed it so you can walk through it, by the way. Councilman Bill Peduto was instrumental in finding it and says under that bridge serves as sort of an outdoor warehouse. Still no word, by the way, on how his art ended up under that 62nd Street Bridge. Michelle Wright, Channel 4 Action News.